Good morning, friend. Today we will see the calibration of rail testing. So this is our rail testing machine made by Paras. This is digital rail tester DRT711D. So this is on off button for just start the button. Next we are seeing that here test, calibrate, open, color and quit. So first we have to do the calibration. So we will press the calibration. Next we have to do the calibration for the any particular channel. So this is 0 degree 1 number, 70 degree center forward 2 number, 70 degree center backward 3 number, gauge face forward 4 number, gauge face backward 5 number, like that non gauge face forward 6 number, non gauge face backward 7 number. So same for the left rail, it is for the upper portion for the right rail and lower portion for the left rail, like that 8 number 0 degree, 9 number center forward, 10 number center backward, 11 number gauge face forward, 12 number gauge face backward, like that 30 number non gauge face forward, 40 number non gauge face backward. So this is DRT machine, so total 14 probe will be provided. In that one, 2 number 0 degree, that will be the 4 megahertz double crystal, and 12 number 70 degree 2 megahertz. So this is 0 degree 4 megahertz double crystal, this is for the 0 degree testing, and this is 70 degree probe. This is made of Paras and here frequency is 2 megahertz. In real testing, our 0 degree will be the 4 megahertz, but all other 70 degree probe will be the 2 megahertz. So first we will see the calibration for this 0 degree. This is 0 degree double crystal. So first we will see the calibration for the 0 degree. So this is channel number 1. This is for the 0 degree. So in that one we have to change the gain, delay, range, like that angle. So we will see one by one. This is gain. Next delay. Delay is the function by that one we can move the echo from right to left or left to right. So this is for calibration. Next range. For 0 degree we are taking range 200, and for 70 degree range will be the 165. Like that we have to see the angle for that probe. So in last one it is angle. So here angle is 0. If it is not 0, then we have to make it 0, or if it is 70 degree, then we have to make the angle 70 by this plus or minus button. From here it will decrease or increase. So first we will see the calibration for this 0 degree. For that we will check the beam path. So this is a steel block and this is IIW block. Calibration for 0 degree we can use anyone, either a steel block or IIW block. So we will see by this steel block. Here depth or thickness of this block is 100, and here also 100. So we will set by this steel block. So for that we have to press this edit button. So now all the function will work as a for 0 degree. This is 0 degree. So now we will place this 0 degree at this location. So we have got one equoid here. So now it is touching the 100%. So first we will decrease the gain. So now height of the echo is decreasing. Height of this echo is decreasing. For rapid change, we can opt fraction bigger size like that 2. So it will reduce by 2. So now here we have to see beam path. Here it is 103, but actual beam path or depth of this block is 100. So we have to make the beam path 100. So this is calibration. Here beam path showing 103, but actual beam path is 100. So we have to make this beam path 100. This is calibration for the 0 degree. So we will change the delay and we will make it 103 to 100. So for that we have to increase or decrease the delay. Here this is delay. By this delay we can shift the echo from right to left or left to right. So we will now change. So now it is 103, 102, 101, 100. So this is actual depth, this is 100, and beam path also showing 100. So now calibration for this 0 degree is completed. So this is the process for the calibration for the real testing 0 degree. We have to shift the echo at their proper depth, proper location, proper beam path. Here beam path or depth is 100. So we have to make the beam path 100. This is the calibration. Okay, thank you.